guys, welcome back to Dom's Tech Chat. So today we're going to talk about how I passed the Azure Fundamentals Exam in 10 days for free. So stay tuned. Okay, so for the Azure Fundamentals Exam, the important part is how did I get a $100 test voucher for free? So if you look down in my bio, you're going to see a link for the Microsoft Azure events. Microsoft basically has training days a couple times a week, different exams, where you go for 2 days and they train you on the exam, and after you attend, you get a free voucher for going. Now, the events are totally virtual. They're normally 2 days. It's about 2 to 3 hours each day, and you just join from your computer, and they're not interactive, so do with that information what you may. Once you attend, you get that free exam voucher, I want to say about 2 to 3 days later, and then you're good to go. You get to go take your test. Now, here we go in terms of preparation. You got the free voucher. How do you make the best of it? You don't want to waste this opportunity. So I actually studied for my Azure Fundamentals exam in about 10 days. So I used 3 resources. I used a Pluralsight videos, I used the Microsoft Learn reading materials, and I use the Whizlabs practice tests. Now you'll probably notice over time as we do more of these certification videos, you'll notice I use the same formula every time. I like to do a video first, I like to read, and I like to do my tests. It's just what works best for me. Whatever works best for you, feel free to tune this to whichever process works best for you, but this is just what works for me. So in terms of what I did first, it was the Pluralsight video course. So for the Pluralsight video course, it normally is about $29 a month. They had a deal for the month of April, so I got it for free. Pluralsight does run these deals every once in a while, so I would keep an eye out. If you're seeing this video, check the Pluralsight website, see if you can find any deals that are coming up, anything that's ongoing, see if you can get a good course. It was a really great course, but if it's not for sale or if you're not getting it for free, I honestly wouldn't recommend it. Not because it's not a great course, but just because it's not so much better than what is out there for free that you have to spend your money on it. So if you are going with the free option, I would recommend the Tim Warner YouTube course. So if you look down in the bio, you're going to see a link to the YouTube playlist for Tim Warner. I have heard great things about it. I didn't use it personally for my studying, but in preparation for this video, I did go through and just watch a couple of them just to see if it was in comparison to Pluralsight and if it was applicable for what I saw on the actual test. And it was. I can't recommend enough. I've heard good things about it, so that is my option I would recommend to you guys for free. Now moving on to the reading materials. If you go on the Microsoft website, when you look up the Azure 900, you're going to see a link for the Microsoft Learn materials. It's going to take you to a learning path. I cannot recommend these enough because you are getting training straight from Microsoft themselves. Microsoft are the people giving you the test. So by going through the materials, you're getting used to their verbiage, the type of words that they use, getting used to the way that they like to phrase things, you're getting used to the images that you would see on the actual test itself. So if anything, please make sure that you are going through this Microsoft Learn material. Sometimes it might seem a little bit oversimplified or not as complicated as the other resources that you're reading, but it is so important for before taking a Microsoft test. Also, the best part about the Microsoft Learn materials is the sandbox environment. Now, sandbox, basically, when you go into some of the Microsoft Learn modules, you're gonna get something at the top saying that you get a free sandbox license with this lesson. A sandbox basically is a license to Azure. It's a temporary license. It typically lasts around an hour. For that hour, you get to go in, you get to make any resources that you want. You aren't getting charged for it. It's for free. A lot of times you're doing it with a guided exercise. So what you're actually learning, you get to go in. So say we're doing virtual machines, you get to go in and make your own virtual machine. You get to name it, you get to assign it to a subscription, you get to assign it to a region. So you get to actually apply the lessons that you're learning from your other materials. For me, that was really important for making sure that a lot of information was sticking for me. I noticed a lot when I was actually taking the tests that if I needed to recall something, I was going back to those sandbox trainings instead of the other training materials that I was using that referenced the same information. So I can't recommend enough. If you are doing those, take advantage of that sandbox. If you have the time after you finish the assigned lesson, just go around and play a little bit and get used to the different resources that you see there. it's really important for when you're taking an IT test to get as much hands-on experience as possible. So it's a great resource. It's free. Please use it. After I did the Microsoft Learn materials, I like to use the practice test. Now, the Microsoft Learn materials are, like I was saying, it's really good for getting used to the wording, the vocabulary, the pictures, but I noticed that their questions at the end of the module do not typically match up with the type of questions they put on the test, which is fair. They don't want to make it just a one-for-one match, but Whizlabs, those practice tests I took, were a great way to get used to the way Microsoft does their tests. They use a lot of the same phrasing in their questions. They use a lot of the same format of their questions so that you can get an expectation of what you're gonna see on test day. So for the Whizlabs, that was the one resource I did pay for. I believe at the time I bought it, it was $12. When I just checked their website before filming this, it was around $16. So it looks like it does fluctuate depending on the day or whatever sale they have going on. Do not pay full price for it. If you go on there and you see it's the full $32, $33, just wait a day. It typically will go back on sale. But if it's around that $16, $12 price point, it's absolutely worth every penny. With the test, you get 6 practice tests. They include a free 7th practice test, but it's the free one and it's honestly not great. I tried it, I wasn't impressed. I would stick with the 6 premium tests. Those were really great because what happens is when you get something wrong, you not only get the paragraph about why the answer is correct, but you also get a link to the relevant paragraph in the official Microsoft documents. So the reason that's really helpful is say you're going through the test and you realize that you keep getting things wrong about virtual machines. Virtual machines just is not clicking. For some reason, that's not working for you. You get a link to the official Microsoft page that's going to break down everything about virtual machines. So you can go through and just read the entire article. And it's really great for a refresher on some of the things that just aren't clicking for you or that you need to do a deeper dive on. So I really appreciated that. That was really helpful for me when I was testing. Like I was saying before, I do like to make note of all the questions that I got wrong in the practice test. So if I'm going through and I'm reviewing, I see that I got something wrong, I typically write down the question, I write down the answer that I put, I write down the correct answer, and then I include that little blurb that they give you on why the answer is correct. What I was doing is when I would go through a test, I would just go back and review everything I got wrong before moving on to the next test. So as I went on, of course, my score just gradually improved from that. By the time I got around test day, I was around, I want to say 88% on the Whizlab test. Not amazing, but I was doing a rush job because I was trying to get it done in 10 days. So I took it, I passed. So if you need a scale and where you should be on the Whizlabs test, that's around where I was before I took the test. The Whizlab tests are a little bit, I wouldn't say they're harder than the Microsoft tests. It's just sometimes they're a bit more specific, but the things that they are specific on is still stuff that you should know for the test. So take the Whizlab test. If you aren't on a time crunch like I am, take the extra day to try to get yourself up in the 90s, and then you should be all good for the test, the actual official Microsoft test. In terms of how I did it in 10 days. So again, I was rushing. I am in school right now for my bachelor's in information technology. I decided to get my Azure Fundamentals exam. I started the process the week after midterms. So the way my school schedule was, I really only had a solid 10 days where my assignments were light enough that I had time to study for the certification. So I tried to get it done within that window. So the way I did it is I took 3 days for the Pluralsight videos. Took 3 days to do those. One of those days was a Saturday where I did spend basically just 8 to 10 hours just watching videos. I took notes during every video just because videos are normally my first introduction to the topic. I don't like to just skim over them or put them in the background while I'm doing something. I want to make sure I'm actually taking notes and paying attention. So I took notes for all the videos. It took me a little bit longer than the actual playtime because I had to keep pausing, but it was worth it for me. Everything stuck a lot better for me. I did include in the bio the template to my note-taking. I will do a video on how I take my notes in Notion because Notion is a great app, especially when you're doing note-taking for IT certification. So I will do a separate video on that, but for now my template is down there. If you're familiar with it or if you just want to get used to Notion, feel free to use that template. It's really helpful in terms of this specific certification. So after I did my note taking for the videos, I took another 3 days doing the Microsoft Learn modules. Again, I did spend a Sunday because I finished my videos on Saturday. I did the Microsoft Learn modules on Sunday, and so I could spend a good amount of time on it. I think I spent about 8 hours that day just going through the modules. For that one, I did not worry as much on note taking. I took notes if it was something that didn't stick from the videos, or if it seemed kind of foreign to me, or if I was struggling with it. But if it was something that I understood the first time, I didn't waste my time just taking notes on it over again just to take notes. When I got to the practice test, like I said before, I took 3 days doing the practice test. I took notes on the ones that I got wrong, and I reviewed them before the next test. Now, when it came to actual test day, so day 10, I don't like to study on test day. It doesn't help me. I feel like it just raises my anxiety level. Apparently, it's scientifically proven that last minute cramming the day of the test doesn't actually help you. So on the day of the test, I was working. I took my test at 8 p.m. I got off of work at 5. So I spent that whole day. I would just lightly read my notes, but I wasn't trying to commit anything to memory or do any quizzing. It was more just kind of keeping everything fresh on the brain. And I just focused on relaxing. I spent a couple hours before the test just doing some things for me, doing some type of like self-care activity to take my mind off the test and not get wrapped up in my brain. So I can't recommend enough that the day of the test to try to be as relaxed as possible, sleep, eat, make sure your testing environment is set up correctly, because Microsoft does like to see where you're testing. You can't have monitors and things of that sort on the desk. Focus more on that than trying to cram last minute. Just relax. It makes it a lot easier. If you know the information, you're gonna know it before that day. Anything you learn the day of is not really gonna help you, and it's not really gonna stick. You wanna actually learn the material so that you can use it for your job. Now, in terms of the certification, it has been about a week since I passed it. I did include it on my LinkedIn, and I have noticed a spike in the amount of messages I am getting from recruiters ever since I did put that certification on there. I did previously already have my A+ certification, but the Azure certification seems to be bringing on more attention, which is nice. I do plan on doing a video update in a couple of months just to see if that certification has helped my career at all. I am also currently studying for the Azure 104 certification, so I will do another one of these videos explaining my process for that, how I did it, how I passed, how I got it for free, because I got that one for free too, you know. I'm always going to tell you guys how I got my certifications for free so you can do the same thing. We try to get it for as cheap as possible over here. So stay tuned, guys, if you want to see more about my journey with my Azure certifications. If you want to know more about my path in IT, hit that subscribe button, hit that bell so that you can get notified when I put up my next video about my certifications. If you do have any questions about any of the resources I use, or if there's any resource that you think is good that I didn't mention, feel free to drop it down in the comments. Till then, see you guys next video.